In this video, we broke some rules while RV living at a Cracker Barrel.
The reason I'm telling you guys all this is because we don't want to ruin it for future RVers out there.
Let's just say that this was a very unique situation.
Ooh, that might have been it, right there.
That was shoot.
When parking at RV overnighters like this, these are the things that every RV camper should know about. Today, we want to share with you common mistakes that are made and the relatable stressors that RV life can have on us while traveling.
So you guys probably have it all figured out, don't you? You guys are probably pros by now and you're like, dude, get a grip.
Hey everyone, my name is Renee and I've been living with my husband Kyle in an RV full-time since 2017. Oh yeah, our cat Dexter too. In last week's video, we did an amazing breakdown of boondocking on a Texas beach for multiple nights on a single battery. Make sure you head on over to see our other videos after watching this one. Today, the drama of RV life starts off in Matagorda, Texas. Let's go!
Good morning, sunshine.
Good morning. It's gonna be an intense travel day. I hope everyone's ready. I mean, we literally have like 2 6-hour back-to-back travel days. Now, the GPS says 5 hours and 20 minutes, but that is never the case. Guys, don't listen to the GPS. What we've learned is Google and Apple Maps tells us a small amount of time, and RV Life app tells us like way too long of a time. I don't know who to believe. We just go by Hank's time, right?
Always Hank's time. That's what I'm saying. Okay, I think our friends are waiting for us.
Are they even ready to deal with us for like, no, like the radio? They're ready for the radio.
Yeah, they're like waiting there by the radios. They're like, hello, are we leaving? Not yet. It's Hank's time still.
Oh wait, I think they have something for us. So let's go check it out. Travelers, RV travelers in the wild. Be very careful, because it's 8 in the morning. You don't want to approach RV travelers the wrong way. So just follow my lead, guys.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How's everyone doing?
Great.
Just ease into it. Did everyone sleep okay?
Oh yeah.
Okay good.
We got a long haul today and we don't have time for these pee breaks. We got a long ways to go. So get it done in
what
the car.
What is that?
Get it done in the car.
Thank you so much. I've been waiting for this my whole life.
What is that? Who's using these? Comment below.
Did you guys get some in there?
We did.
Show them if you got them.
In flight service. Here, take these in case you need to throw up.
I'm gonna use it to hold my snacks.
Spoken like a true RVer right there, I tell you what.
Everyone, when you use it, we're gonna wave it out the window. So just yeah. Signal to everyone else it's been used.
If you're using these on travel days, like how much is too much? Asking for a friend.
All right, everyone, let her rip, let her rip. Not that kind of let her rip. This day's starting off great already.
Bridges.
I'm gonna go on a limb and I'm gonna say having a kid is gonna be cake compared to owning a cat. The reason I say that is because eventually the child grows up according to your directions. Cats? No. It's this false sin craziness all the time.
For 7 years.
Yeah. And we got plenty more to come. I feel like all the parents and grandparents are waving at TV like, you just wait, Hanks.
You well, just wait.
I will. I'll just wait.
We're gonna wait. Like, we're gonna wait.
Long driving days make for really stressful days. It's just like no matter how much you're prepared for it, and in your mind you know it's gonna take all day, you know the first few hours go really smoothly, then people start getting hungry, people start needing to pee, we gotta make multiple stops to fuel up the trucks, and I don't know, it's just added stressors throughout the day of traveling.
Change of plans. We just found out that the park that we were gonna go boondock in tonight does not allow RVs anymore.
Can I just say, I don't travel super well when I'm hungry and tired. I don't know. It's just one of those things.
And this is a learning lesson. Like, do your research before you make these plans.
Just want to keep it really real with y'all. Show you that, no, you are not alone when you feel like this at times. You feel a little stressed out. Can't find a place to park the rig. Animals are crying. Tummies are rumbling. Whatever it may be, don't worry. Everyone in RV life feels that way. So you're not alone.
So I think what we're doing, Cracker Barrel? All three rigs, we're gonna pull into the barrel.
Yeah.
And we're gonna see what happens.
Yeah.
Tell you what's a guarantee though for tonight, no matter what. We're gonna have power.
She's throwing shade.
When I get in situations like this, and always having you guys here keeps me humble and well aware of my surroundings. So I gotta reel it back in. Yeah, just always try to reframe that mindset, Carl. Talking to myself, not you guys. You guys probably have it all figured out, don't you? You guys are probably pros by now, and you're like, dude, get a grip. Thank you, I needed that.
I think I'm driving.
Dirt lot flash.
Oh boy.
Oh boy. We're getting there fast.
Where's Carl and Dexie?
Hi, come on. Are you ready to go bye-byes? And that's it.
Just got off the phone with Rainey. She went ahead with the little Bebop car to scope it out. It's barely 4 o'clock and we're already done driving. It's like, I feel like we should go further almost. I mean, how do you feel? Like, of course I want to be done driving all the time, but sometimes you're just like, do we keep going? You know, like, and when it gets dark, do we pull over?
Great questions. You know? Great questions. I don't know. I don't know how I feel about life right now. Kind of like 50-50.
You're tired.
We pull over, we're good. We keep going, I'm good. No, I'm not tired. I took a little nippy nap.
All right, let her rip. We're gonna see where should we park. Three rigs, we don't know. Okay, you're pulling in, like, the dirt lot is after the Best Western. Ooh, that might have been it, right there.
That was...
Shoot.
Okay, that one stuck up on me.
Hey, pull into, we missed our shot there. You wanna pull into that dirt lot if you're behind us.
Stuck up
there. Rainey, are you within range of the radio? Can you hear me?
You're not coming through for me.
We missed the dirt lot that Rainey was telling us to turn into. Yeah, that's where we are. We'll pull in here and like figure it out or something. Sorry, Rainey.
That came up so fast.
I agree, and on all stays in the reviews, people said that they just they were told to park in the back like this.
Park in the back. We got that covered.
Echo that, I'm going for the shade.
It's the little things. When you get to boondocking, the shade helps a lot, especially in the desert light climates.
Yeah, because look how hot it is right now.
82, read it and weep. We'll be okay.
We can always jump in the truck and cool off. Or we can,
we can't do that.
The Harris family has a solar and everything.
That's cheating. You're a cheater.
I ain't gotta impress anybody.
Did you guys blow past it?
Yeah, I was like,
oh, I did too.
Good old Cracker Barrel for the win.
I am exhausted.
Oh, yeah, they would know.
This is RV life.
You have to do this when you stay in a cracker barrel.
All right, Keith and Rainey went inside to ask permission, I guess. We're doing it right. We're like getting the permission and everything. Okay, here they come. Let's see what they say.
We're good.
Yeah, we're fine.
We're good? Were they excited? Were they like, come on?
They were the nicest I think I've ever like had a cracker barrel.
Yeah, they asked permission and
they're good to stay. They're like, yeah, we're not gonna get rid of them, I guess. So just let them stay. I think one really cool thing, a little trick that we do, having a lifted truck, we slightly ride nose high. The RV sits over the cap of the truck and it slightly rides nose high. So to counteract that, finding just a grade that's ever so slightly on the downward slope, we take full advantage of that because it all levels out for sleeping time. So I'm liking those vibes. No, we don't really have any problems with the fifth wheel and towing nose high. We've been doing it for 5 years now. But good questions. I like these. Keep them coming.
How the truck is, I said if we park on a downward incline, then we'll be completely level. We ran into an issue, though. Blew past all the open roads places to stop. I was looking at the map, and I was like, oh, like, if we want to fuel up tomorrow, I don't think we'll make it. There is a pilot injunction. You know, it's not part of the program, but it's a truck stop.
Can I also say just how much I enjoyed these times because it reminds me of how little you actually need to live. Those little butterflies that were building up in my stomach when we first hit the road, yeah, it's coming full circle and it's happening again because it's like, this is exciting. We're actually doing it. Yeah, 5 years later, we're still actually doing this. That's cool. And best yet, we're doing it with you guys. Even better. Hot diggity dog. I mean cat. Cat, I meant cat.
All right, let's have a conversation about RV parking at the Cracker Barrel. How did we find this Cracker Barrel and how did we know we could park here overnight? Couple apps that will tell you this. We mostly use the All Stays app. Now I talk a lot about All Stays Pro, which is a browser form program, but they also offer an app and I think they currently just upped the price to $20. It's a one-time fee. We've had this app since we first started and it's my favorite go-to for finding Cracker Barrels, Walmarts, rest stops on the road. Another way to find it is Campendium. Now that one is free. I think you just have to sign up with your email, but that one will tell you where there's parking such as like Walmart, rest stops, Cracker Barrels on there. If you watch our content, you also know that we do not have a generator or solar or good batteries or an inverter. We have nothing. We have one 12 volt battery that we're relying on. So we will not be sleeping with the AC tonight. And it's toasty. I'm really hoping it cools down. A lot of Cracker Barrels will have designated parking spots for RVs where it's just like a long pull through site and you just line up. This Cracker Barrel does not have sites like that. And they literally told us where we parked here in the back is perfect. Cause you'll notice we have our slides out. Keith and Rainey have their awning out. And you gotta be careful when it comes to putting slides and awnings out because if you're in those like pull through sites for RVs, you really don't wanna be infringing on the next person's site. Because we're parked here in the back and we fit perfectly within the site, we decided it's probably okay that we have our slides out. We got permission, they said stay where you are. Here's the other thing with Cracker Barrel parking. They let you park here for free, so you better go and get either breakfast or dinner or both from them. People like to ask, do you disconnect when you go to these places? Do you stay hooked up? My thing is stay hooked up because the whole point of coming to these places, because it's easy in, easy out, and now tomorrow we don't have to worry about hooking up, we can just go. The reason I'm telling you guys all this is because we don't want to ruin it for future RVers out there. Cracker Barrel is such a great place to overnight because it's not noisy. Walmart could be a little, it could be a little loud. You get like the 2 a.m. kids that roll up in vehicles, just play loud blasting music. I get it, they're bored, it's fine. But not fine when you're trying to sleep in the RV. The only noise that I hear people complain about is when they come empty like the dumpsters in the morning or the truck service deliveries come super early. But hey, the whole point is to be here and then hit the road early. You know what? It's almost time to get some dinner.
Hey, have you ever wanted to help support us but have no idea how? Well, help us by watching our other videos or catching up on some oldies. See you over on the next one.